The Defense Department team should arrive next week. The Leech have 22 members to assist with the COVID surge. At Hennepin Health, also known as HCMC, they welcome the help from Uncle Sam.
We are currently having very long wait times in the emergency department, way longer than we would like to see, sometimes over a day. And we're also full to the point where we're not always able to take those transfers into our level one trauma center.
The other Department of Defense team will be going to the St. Cloud Hospital.
At this point in time, there are very, very few teams available to be deployed across the whole nation. So the fact that Minnesota is getting two of them is great good news.
Governor Walz said he's unlikely to declare another peacetime emergency because vaccinations and testing are both running in high gear now.
What I need from people is I need them to be vaccinated, and I need some relief around some of the regulations and the ability to take the pressure off of the hospitals.
The governor would like to call the legislature back for a special session on essential worker bonuses, drought relief, and bills to give hospitals more flexibility. But there's a high risk that Senate Republicans would use the session to fire Health Commissioner Jan Malcolm.
I can't afford to lose someone at the Department of Health who is getting these vaccines out and making a difference, and that's the threat that is hanging there.
In the meantime, on the front lines of the COVID surge, a plea from Dr. Daniel Hoodie.
I just want to highlight the top three things that Minnesotans can do right now is get vaccinated, get vaccinated, get vaccinated.
Now, Senate Majority Leader Jeremy Miller today released a statement saying Senate Republicans are still very willing to work with Governor Walz, but it's up to him to call a special session. Miller, in his statement, steered clear of the whole Jan Malcolm controversy. Back to you.